Revered leader and an outstanding player who won many accolades from both his peers and opponents. Nkohla's club, Orientals, together with seven others, broke away from the bottles of the African Rugby Union and formed the Kwazakhele Rugby Union, KwaRU, in 1971. The new union joined forces with the non-racial South African Rugby Union, and Nkohla led KwaRU to two SA Cup finals in 1972 and 74.
There's one match that Bomza played when we were still in the South African Rugby Board. That was 1968 in Joburg, where Danny Craven was there. And then he played his heart out to Bomza. And then Danny Craven said after the game, if he had a white paint, he would paint Bomza white and then play for the Springboks. And then I said, that's an insult.
No, Bomza was good, was encouraging the players. He was good, man. Was encouraging all the time, encouraging Bomza.
He was also a family man.
He would look for our needs instead of caring for himself. Even though he was very sick, but he was concerned about us and he did not want us to worry about him.
Nkohla's passing comes at a time when the nation is still mourning the passing of former SARU and Western Province captain Sally Fredericks, who died a few weeks ago. Nkohla leaves behind his wife Bella, six children and two siblings. He will be buried on Monday. Tabo Daniels, SABC News, Port Elizabeth.